and we'll have a little fun too.
Everything you need.
Every morning.
In one place. Wake up with Channel 3 Eyewitness News Today.
3 in your town with John Martin, Mondays and anytime on our apps.
We are so happy this morning to have Chris Berryman on the show. He is representing Dalton, which doesn't get a lot of play, sadly, on 3 Plus U, but he is in a new position with a fantastic organization in Dalton called the Greenhouse Child Advocacy and Sexual Assault Center. So good to see
you. Thank you. It's great to see you.
And you were telling me, not to make you speak out of school too much, but that you are so enjoying your time in Dalton to see the sense of community and support that they have there.
It's true. Dalton really bands together. They have amazing services for their community and just all they have to offer, all ages, all people. It is a fantastic area of the East Coast, and I'm just happy to be there.
At the Tennessee Valley. So
absolutely.
You have, obviously what you're dealing with every day at the Greenhouse has got to be emotionally taxing. For the staff who works there to help these children and their families through a very, very difficult and trying time. And you need all that support that you can get, financially included. So y'all have got a really fun fundraiser coming up in October that should get a lot of people eager to take part.
Well, we're hoping so. So the Greenhouse Child Advocacy Center serves Whitfield and Murray counties, and it's a sexual assault center as well, providing advocacy, therapy, interviews, exams, and as you said, sadly, it's much needed. Mm-hmm. And if it's needed, we're so happy to serve and to fill that void. And so our upcoming fundraiser, we're really counting on that community spirit we just talked about, as well as folks in Chattanooga to come down and join us. It is the third annual Rock N Rappel. And this fundraiser is unique, I think, because it has two parts.
Okay.
So the daytime part is when people sign up at rocknrappel.com. You raise dollars, much like you did in the days we might remember with the walkathon, the bowl-a-thon, the read-a-thon.
Right.
So you raise dollars your own way, and your reward for raising those dollars is you get to safely, supervised by another company, not us, you get to rappel down the 5-story landmark building in downtown Dalton. The view is phenomenal, so much fun, music, crowds cheering, it's fantastic.
And what a thing to be able to say that you've done. That's going to open up party conversation for the rest of your life, to say that you rappelled down a building.
It is, as you're walking in downtown Dalton, hey, I rappelled down that.
Right. But then, now that one is for people who raise the donation
Correct.
Dollars. But then y'all are giving something to the community that night, right?
We are, again, hearkening back to that great Dalton spirit. In the Burr Performing Arts Park, which is adjacent to the landmark building, the old Dalton Hotel, we have Resurrection, a Journey tribute. And so a Journey cover band.
You're taking me back to my teenage years.
I'm skating right back in time with you. They are phenomenal. Again, their name's Resurrection. And you can go to their website, which their website has a great name, notjourney.com. And see their video. If you close your eyes, it's Steve Perry.
Really? I was about to say that very phrase to you.
So yeah, so you're going to see a lot of people in the Burr Performing Arts Park our ages just losing their mind, because it's the closest we're ever going to get to Journey.
That's awesome.
And that's open to the public. It's family friendly. There'll be food and beverages and food trucks, so those things will be for sale. And all our rappellers are going to be there, and their families and their support systems. And that is, as you said so well, what we're doing for the community. We just want to put that opportunity out there.
So I had somebody on the show earlier this week from Chattanooga, Pam Ladd, with the Partnership for Families, Children, and Adults. And she was talking that October is actually Domestic Violence Month, Awareness Month. Child sexual assault is not removed from that generally. I mean, very often that can be a domestic situation. So have y'all seen, I don't know what you know about your numbers down there in Dalton, but has COVID increased the problem for you there?
Now, I want to be careful not to misspeak, and so those data are still being collected.
Okay.
I can say anecdotally from those parties, all our partner agencies, that is certainly what we are feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Our services, the need for our services has increased by 32% since January. And again, the feeling, the hard data isn't there, the feeling by experts is that it's because children are going back to school, they're now in a safer environment where they can report seeing domestic violence issues,
right,
as you and Pam Ladd were discussing. or sexual improprieties, abuse, assault. And
with the child advocacy side,
yes,
of the greenhouse, is that where you step in if there is just a custodial issue or if there is another kind of a need in a home, if the grades are a problem, whatever?
Absolutely. We make a lot of referrals from the Greenhouse Child Advocacy Center because our partners are always right there with us, mm-hmm, in all these types of cases. And last year we made 462 referrals,
wow,
to outside agencies to meet either the needs we didn't cover or, as you put so well, those needs that are parallel and,
right,
running alongside with the other issues.
Okay, so let's get back to the need then on October 23rd to,
okay,
have as many people get in the game, if you will. You need them to sign up ahead of time, right, to get those,
correct,
dollars raised now.
And there's still time.
Okay.
Because when you sign up at rocknrappel.com, you get a host of fundraising tools that you can pop on your social media, pop in emails, Facebook Messenger, all of that to get that support.
And you, I think, went up on the building to get some video for us.
I did.
Did you kind of lose your, was your stomach turning a bit? Is it higher than you think?
In a good way, it is. It's a little over 60 feet high because you're rappelling down 5 stories and then a little bit of a step level.
Okay.
So it's about 62 feet is what you'll be rappelling.
Be brave, raise the money, and know you're doing it for a fantastic cause. So as Chris has told you repeatedly, it's rockinrappel.com. Sign up, get those dollars raised, show off as you rappel down the building, and then go listen to the Steve Perry sound alike.
It's incredible. You wait.
That evening. Good to see you.
You too.
Flowers are fighters. That's why the Alzheimer's Association Walk to End Alzheimer's is full of them. Because flowers find a